You will see how to create a professional and super awesome website using the latest and greatest Elementor version 2.0. The website which you're going to create will be perfect for any kind of businesses. And to create this website, you don't need to know any kind of coding languages or such. It's just simple drag and drop. So first, let's see the demo website which we have created. And before that, make sure to subscribe to my channel and also click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. Now as you can see on your screen, this is the website that we'll be creating in this video. At the top, we have this beautiful nav bar. As you can see, it is a transparent nav bar. We don't have any background color, it is transparent. At the left hand side, we have this logo, and at the right hand side, we have our menu. After that, we have the heading, and as you can see, this heading is using a very beautiful animation. That is the typing animation. And there are so many different animations that you can choose from. After that, we have the subheading, as you can see, the subtitle or the subheading. And after that, we have this beautiful call to action button. Now, as I said to you earlier, that creating a website with Elementor is really easy. In fact, it was always very easy. But Elementor's latest version, which is 2.0, which we'll be using in this video, has made it more easier. Now, if you want to see a demo, let me show you. If you want to make any changes in this website, for example, if you want to change the title, or if you want to change the color of this button, or if maybe if you want to change the background image, it's really easy. You just click on this button which says edit with Elementor here at the top. Now once you do so, you'll see a screen which looks something like this. Now suppose you want to change this thing, okay, this text. So what you do, you just click on over here and you'll get this pop-up over here at the left hand side. Now as you can see, the first thing is how to make a website. Now if you want to make any changes over there, you can just type in your thing. For example, I am typing Nayar Sheikh over here. Now as you can see, instead of that, now it says Nayar Sheikh. And suppose if you want to change the image in the background, what do you do? You click over here, you go to style, because that will come under styling. You have this image over here, you just delete this image, click on this plus button, upload any new file that you want, and you just upload it. It is that simple. So let's see how to do that. Let's upload maybe this image this time. Select this image, click on insert media. Now as you can see, the image is totally changed, and this is also looking very, very beautiful. So this is how easy it is to create a website using Elementor version 2.0. And the greatest thing about Elementor 2 is the blogs. Now that is the latest thing. Okay, for example, all this website, if you see, everything is created using different blogs. Okay, you import the blog and you just design it. I'll show that in the video. Just stay tuned, you'll learn everything. So this is how, I hope you got an idea about how easy it is to make any changes in this website. Now let's continue to the demo website and let's see how our demo website looks like. Okay, so we have already seen the top section. Now let's see what we have next. Now as you can see, the beautiful animation as we scroll down, this is our second section, the our services section. Okay, we have three different services over here. When we hover over this section, as you can see, we get this background color, the border color, which is looking really nice. We have this button, and if you notice one thing, we are using two colors, for example, that pink color and greenish type of color, and we are setting that as primary and secondary color, and we'll be using these two colors throughout the website. Now that gives a very professional look to the website, and it improves the design of the website. Also, if you see the logo, the icons which I have created, I'll show you how to create these different icons. It is really, really easy. Here also, I have used the same color, the pinkish color and this greenish color. So I'll show you how to do this as well. Now, when I hover this icon, as you can see, it it increases in size. It glows, okay, or it grows. That is what the animation is called. Now we have many different animation for this as well, but we'll see those things later on, okay. Now let's move on to the next section. Now this is the next section, the stats section. We have some statistics like 85% support, 74% developing, 90% design. Obviously it is really easy. You can change the number, you can change the text over here. It's all up to you. Then after that, we have the features section. At the left hand side, we have this beautiful image. And at the right hand side, we have some features, and we are using these icons throughout the website. And again, if you see, we are using the primary color over here, which is some pinkish type of color. And here we have three different features: design, marketing, and development system. Then we have the portfolio or the gallery section. Then after that, we have the get in touch section. Then we have the our client section. Okay, this is really nice. You know, if you see the get in touch section at the left hand side, we have this beautiful contact form. At the right hand side, we have this map. I'll show you how to integrate the map, how to create this form and how to use it. Okay. Then after that, we have the client section. When you hover over this, you can see the beautiful animation. We have this divider, which is used throughout the website. And at the footer, we again have a call to action. Okay. We have some text over here. For example, if your website is related to something different, you can change the text and you can change the link of this call to action button, because the basic aim of creating a landing page or a home page is to get the leads, okay, to make the user or the customer click on that button and they can, you know, apply for the services of that we are providing. They can purchase and buy our services. Now this was the home page. I'll show you how to create more pages like about us, services and contact us page. Now let's see how the about us page looks like. Okay, so this is our about us page. As you can see, the top section is a very beautiful section. We are using a very beautiful design over here. Now if you see the top section here, we have the title, the divider and some text, and after that we have this curve over here, and we have three different things about us, like our history, our mission, our vision. And again, if you see the animation when I hover this section or this column, you'll see a very thin shadow. As you can see the difference, now I'm not hovering over it, but when I do so, you'll see this beautiful shadow. Now that improves the design of the website. Again, as I said you earlier, we'll be using all these icons throughout the website, all the icons and images, because that really gives a very beautiful and very professional look to the website. After that, we have our story. As you can see, the title, a small icon and something about your company. Then we have our members. When I hover this, any one of this image, as you can see, the image shifts towards the right. Yeah, it gets overlaid by the black color, and we have the name of the person and their designation in our company. So we'll see how to do this as well. Then again, if you notice one thing, the bottom two section, that is the our client section and the call to action section, is same that we have seen in the home page. Now that is because, you know, what happens is we want these two sections, because these two are very important sections. The call to action section, because as I said you earlier, the main aim is to get more leads, more customer. We want the customer to click on that button, contact us and, you know, take some services from us. So that is what the main aim is. So that's why you'll see these two sections in all the pages. Okay. Now, once you create this section in the home page, you don't have to create these different sections again and again in different pages. I'll show you a very simple technique how you can use one section throughout the website. So we don't have to create this section again. We can just save that section and use it over here. Okay. So I hope you like the about us page. Now let's move on to the services page. So this is our services page. If you notice one thing, the design is very much similar, because that is very important. We have to maintain the consistency. The design should be similar throughout the website. Okay. Only the content and different changes, different things should change. Now here also we have our title, the divider, subtitle and three different services. Okay. For example, print design, web design, you know, and again, we have three different icons over here if you see, and we have different colors. Then after that, we have some more services like brand strategy, graphic design, consultants, web development and so on. And as I said you earlier, we have selected two color as the primary and secondary color, and that is the color that we'll be using throughout the website, and that is what we have done over here. Then after that, as I said you earlier, we have the client and the call to action section again over here. We'll also see how to create a contact us page just like this. Again, we have a very similar section over here. But if you see over here, the contact form is over here. Now this is looking really, really amazing. I'll show you how to do this, how you can achieve this design. And after that, we have some contact informations like a phone number, email address, timing, and some contact details. You can put in your address over here. And at the bottom, we have the map. Okay. Now, if you see at the footer, at the bottom footer, we have this copyright text. I'll show you how to change that, how to put in your own copyright text over there. So this was a very short tour, of the demo website that we'll be creating in this video. I hope you guys like the demo website, and if you really like it, if you want to create this website, if you want to learn how to create website using Elementor 2.0, if you want to create the exact same website, then stay tuned. Oh yeah, so to create any kind of website, whether it be an e-commerce website, a social networking website, or a simple business website, we need two basic things, a domain name and a hosting account. Now a domain name is a very simple thing, it's just the name of your website or the URL of your website. For example, google.com, youtube.com, all these things are different domain names. And a hosting, it's also a very simple thing. For example, if you see this section, we have this beautiful image. Then we have some text and some, you know, content over here. So all this content is saved in some computer which is running 24/7 so that anyone who visits your website, they can see the website live. So your website is live 24/7. So all this content, whatever is there on your website, is saved somewhere in some computer which is stored somewhere in the world and it is running 24/7. So that is what a hosting is. Now to create a website, you need both the domain name and a hosting account. Now there are different, in fact, there are many different hosting providers that you can go and purchase, and most of them are good. But what I recommend is TMD Hosting. That is the number one hosting company which I recommend. That is the fastest, most reliable. It uses an SSD, which is really, really awesome because it improves the performance of your website, and it is really nice to use to have an SSD space. It also provides a free domain name, so we don't have to purchase a domain name, and you also get a free SSL certificate. Now as you can see over here, it says secure over here. Now that is what a SSL certificate is. If you don't have this, your website browser, your Chrome browser will say that this website is not secure, which is not a good thing. We don't want the user to come to our website and see that this is not secure. Also, SSL certificates are very useful for SEO purposes. Google ranks high the website which are using SSL certificates. So that is also a very good thing. And as I said, it will improve the performance. It will improve the page speed of your website. So that is the hosting which I recommend. Now, if you can have another option, which is HostGator. So it's all up to you. HostGator is also good, but I recommend TMD more than anything else. So if you want to use TMD, just open a new tab and type in blogdude.com/TMD and press enter. Now, once you do so, you will be redirected to this page. Now, as you can see here, it says shared hosting. There's some discount going on shared hosting. Now we don't want this shared hosting because shared hosting is just the regular hosting, which is very slow, and I don't recommend that. I am recommending cloud hosting, and that is what I use personally on my websites and on my clients' websites. So if you want to use cloud hosting, you'll see a button over here which says get into the cloud now. Click on that button. Now here, as you can see, we have three different packages, the Starter Cloud, Business Cloud, and Enterprise Cloud. Now let's see what are the different features that we get in TMD and why I recommend TMD over other hosting companies. So let's see what we get over here. Now the first feature, if you see over here, is 6-core CPU and 6 GB of DDR4 RAM. So as I just said you that a hosting is nothing but a computer which is running 24/7. It has all your files stored in that computer. So the computer that is storing our website, our data, is a very nice and very fast computer. As you can see, it has got a 6-core CPU, which is a really nice. And it also has 6 GB of DDR4 RAM. So the hosting is a really high quality and fast hosting. Next feature is unlimited bandwidth. Now, unlimited bandwidth is also a very important feature because it is the amount of data that you can transfer on your website. So if you can upload and you can also download unlimited amount of data from your website. So that is also a very important feature. Then after that, we have unlimited SSD space. Now, this is the most important feature. SSD space or SSD is way more faster than the regular HDD. You guys might be aware of that. If you know even basic things about computer, you must know that SSD is way more faster than the HDD. If you don't know, you can just go to Google and type in SSD versus HDD web hosting. You'll see the results. There are many different articles over here. You can read them all and you'll get a very strong, very concrete idea about the difference. If you don't know, you can just click on this images link and open any one of these. So I'm opening the first link, the first image, and here you can see the difference between the regular HDD and the SSD that we'll be using. The speed of SSD is way more better than the regular and boring HDD. In fact, sometimes it is even 30 to 40 times higher. Okay, so the speed of our website will be way more higher than the other websites in the company or in the market, which is very good because it will give us a strong, you know, reputation, and it will increase our SEO score. And that, you know, when your SEO score increases, your website has a very high chance of ranking higher on Google search. So that is really amazing. After that, we have IOPS, and at the bottom it says higher is better. And you can see the difference over here. The difference is just huge. Then after that, we have latency. Now here it says lower is better. And again, if you see over here, this is really, you know, very low, and HDD is very high. And here the lower one is better. Now you know that SSD is really, really amazing. It is way more better than the boring and regular HDD. Now not only that, we have SSD space, we have unlimited SSD space. Now there are few companies that do provide SSD space, but they don't provide unlimited SSD space. They'll provide you something like 1 GB, 5 GB, something like that. But here we have unlimited SSD space, which is another amazing feature. After that, we have unlimited websites hosted. This is also very important. For example, today you're creating this website. Tomorrow you might need to create another website. Now, you know, tomorrow when you create another website, you don't have to purchase a new hosting account again. Here you can host unlimited websites. So whether you want to create one website, 10 websites, 100 different websites, you can host all of them in one single hosting package. You don't have to purchase another hosting package for any one of your future website. This is very, very important. And as I said you earlier, we'll also get a free domain, premium support, free cPanel, and now NGINX, web server, wildcard SSL. Now this is also an insane feature. Now I have said you earlier, I have shown you earlier that this is the SSL certificate is very, very important today to get or to have SSL certificate on your website. Now if you go in the market, if you go to some hosting provider to purchase a SSL certificate, the SSL certificate itself will, you know, cost you around $40 to $100. Now here you're getting wildcard SSL certificate, which means you can use SSL certificate on unlimited number of websites and domains and subdomains. So indirectly you're saving hundreds of thousands of dollars over here. We also get optimum cache, which will improve the performance of our website. We have memory cache instance of 256 MB. Performance is 3 times better than these two plans, and you also get a 60-day money back guarantee. Now all these packages, in fact the business cloud and the enterprise cloud is good, but I don't recommend the starter cloud. The reason is very simple. Here, as you can see here, it says one website hosted. So here you can host only one website. So tomorrow, if you want to create another website, you'll again have to purchase the hosting account. So that is not recommended. You can go with business cloud or enterprise cloud. I recommend enterprise cloud, and I am personally using enterprise cloud. So I'll go with this one. So here you have this get started button. Click on that. Okay, once you do so, you will be redirected to this page. Here you have to enter the domain name which you want for free. So let's type in some domain name over here. I'm typing in nayashake1, and from here you can select the extension. For example, by default the .com extension is selected, but if you want, you can choose or you can select some other extensions as well. For example, if you're creating this website for some organization, you can select .org. If you're creating this website for very specific purpose or for very specific country, like if you're creating this website only for India, then you can select .in. If you're creating this website only for UK, you can select .uk. But for most of you guys, I would recommend to go with .com. That is the most common and most famous one. So type in your website name, select the extension, and click on proceed. Okay, now here you have to enter some basic information about yourself, some contact information like your first name, last name, your email address, phone number, and so on. And after that, you have to select the payment method. If you want to make payment through your credit card, debit card, your ATM card, you can select this thing. You can select the type of card you're using, Visa, MasterCard. And for most of you guys who are watching from India, if most of the Indians have the RuPay card. Now RuPay card is not accepted over here. In fact, RuPay card is not accepted anywhere in the world. It's just, you know, used in India. So if you're using the RuPay card, that card will not be accepted over here. You better get a Visa card or a MasterCard. Okay, so make sure you have one of them. You can also make payment through PayPal if you want. Then we have some important information like your purchase information. Here you have to select the data center location. Now you have to select the one which says nearest to you. For example, here if you see, for me, Singapore says nearest to me or nearest to you, so I'll select that one. And in the period, by default, the 12 month is selected. So I'm selecting the 12 month. Never select the 1 month period, because if you select that, you'll have to pay around $7 extra per month. So by the end of the year, you're paying around $80-$90 extra. So that is not a good idea. Make sure you go with at least 12 months. You can increase that if you want. You can go with 24 or 36 months, but I would recommend you to go with 12 months. That is more better. Now this thing is already ticked in, which is domain privacy. Now if you select this thing, if you tick mark this thing, it is very good because it will protect your information like your contact number, your name, last name from getting leaked. So no one can see who has registered this website, who is the registrar of the website. So that is a good thing. But if you're okay with anyone seeing what is the name and the last name of the person who has registered this website, then you can just untick this thing. Then after that, we have a very, very important thing, which is promo code. Now here you have to enter NAYAR7, NAYAR and numeric 7. Now this coupon code is also given in the video description below. You can check that out. Now once you enter that coupon code, click on this apply button. Now as you can see, it says this promo code gives you 7% of this purchase. And 7% is the highest discount that TMD offers on cloud hosting. So indirectly, you are getting the highest discount possible, which is really nice. Now, once you do all the things that I have shown you, just tick mark over here, I agree to TMD hosting terms of service, and click on checkout. Now, once you click on that checkout button, you will receive a mail from TMD. Now, this is a very, very important mail because it has some really important and crucial information like your username, password, your server IP, name servers, and all these things. So make sure you save this information somewhere. If you have multiple email addresses, forward these to those different email addresses. Just make sure you have all this information secured. Okay. Now at the bottom, you'll see a link which says control panel link, and control panel link is nothing but your domain name slash cPanel. Okay. So whenever you want to visit your control panel, just type in your domain name /cPanel. Okay. So open this control panel link in a new tab and put in your username and password that you got on that email address and click on login. Okay guys, so this is our cPanel. Now it's time to install WordPress on our website. We now have the domain name. Now it's time to install the WordPress on our website. So go at the bottom under this section, which says Softaculous app installer. And the first option over here is WordPress. Click on WordPress. Now click on this install now button, and from here, from the choose domain, choosing the domain that you want to install. Now you will see only one domain over here if you're doing this thing, if you're creating a website for the first time. But because I have used TMD hostings to create unlimited, maybe hundreds of websites, then that's why I was getting so many different domains, but you should see only one. And in the choose protocol, make sure to select this one, the one which says HTTPS. The one with the extension S. Okay, select that one. Then here we have the in directory. Make sure WP is now deleted from here. This thing, this box should be empty. Then you have the site name and site description. Here you have to put in the name of your website and some description or tagline of your website. Then after that, we have a very, very important thing, which is username and password. Now we have to choose, or you have to change the username and password. It is very important. So let me see, let me put in my username and password. Let me hide this thing. And then we have the admin email address. Change this email address and put in your own email address over here. Now come at the bottom and click on this install button. Now, as you can see, WordPress is getting installed on your domain name on your website. It will take few seconds. Don't worry. Now, as I said you earlier, it took few seconds. Now we have two different links. The first one is your website link and the second one is your dashboard or the administrative URL link. So open the second link in a new tab. Now we can get rid of these tabs. Okay guys, so this is the dashboard of your website. This is the WordPress dashboard. This is the place from where you will create pages, you will delete pages, you will do everything related to your website, okay? At first, if you're creating the website for the first time with WordPress, if you're seeing this dashboard for the first time, don't worry. It is really, really easy. I'll explain you everything. Don't worry. We'll see how to create a website step by step. We are not going to miss or skip any single step. So just don't worry. I'll explain you everything. Okay. First, let's see how a website is looking at present. So if you want to see that here at the top left corner, you'll see your website name. When you hover that, you'll see this visit site link. Open this link in a new tab. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is how our website is looking at present. Really, really boring. I don't like the design. We have to create a website similar to this one. Okay, a website beautiful like this one. So let's see how to do that. First, to change the design, we need a different theme. We won't be using this theme. Now a theme is nothing but the design. Okay, if you want to change the design and functions of your website, you change the theme. For example, if you want to change this design, this is the default design. You know, you have this image, big image over here, then we have this very simple looking website. Now I don't like the design, so I want to change the design. So for this we need a different theme. So we'll be using a free theme in this video. We won't be using any premium theme. We'll be using a free theme, a very good theme. So to install that theme, first come back to your dashboard, and whenever you want to come back to your dashboard, you can just type in your website name /wp-admin. This link will get you to your dashboard, to this page. Now from here at the left hand side, you'll see there are many different options, different menu. So the first option that we have to click is on that option which says appearances. So click on appearances. Now here, as you can see, we have three different themes already installed: the 2017, 15 and 16 theme. Now these are default WordPress themes, which are really bad. No one uses this. So what we'll do, we'll just delete it. We'll select this one and delete it, because we don't require it. It is just, you know, consuming a lot of space. Now it's time to install the theme. So click on this add new button. Now in the search theme, search for Ocean WP. Okay. Just type in Ocean WP, OCEANWP. Obviously this is the spelling. And by the way, this theme is also a very good theme for e-commerce website. So if you want to make an e-commerce website, and if you don't have the budget in the beginning to purchase a premium website or premium theme, you can use this theme. This is also a very decent theme for e-commerce websites. Now by the way, if you want to learn how to create an e-commerce website, you will see many different links in the video description below. You can click on them and you will learn everything step by step how to create an e-commerce website. First, obviously watch this video and complete this website. Now we have to install this theme. So you'll see this button over here which says install. Click on that button. So the theme is getting installed on our website. Okay, now once the theme is installed, we have to activate the theme. Okay, so click on this activate button. Okay guys, now once you do so, here it will recommend you few plugins. The first one is Elementor and the second one is Ocean Extra. Now the reason I chose Ocean WP is very simple, because Elementor recommends Ocean WP theme, which is a very decent, very nice and clean theme. So first, what we have to do, we have to install these two plugins from here. So just click on this link which says install plugins. Click on this link. Now tick mark over here, it will select all the things from here, and from the bulk action, select install. Click on apply. Okay, so both our plugins are installed. Now click on this link, return to the dashboard. Fine, so both our plugins are successfully installed and activated. So if you want to see that, from the left hand side, you'll see this option which says plugins. Click on that. Now you have the Elementor and the Ocean Extra, but we have two more plugins over here, which is Akismet and Hello Dolly. We don't need these, so you can tick mark both of them, Akismet and Hello Dolly, and from the bulk action, select delete and click on apply. Okay, so that plugins are gone, which you don't require. Now again, come back to your website. Let's refresh and see the changes. Okay, now this, as you can see, now the design is totally changed. Now if you see, this is also looking very boring. It is not even close to something like this. Now that is because it's time to create or to design the website. Okay, now you have the Elementor over here, but I would highly recommend you to go with the Elementor Pro. Okay, so we have the free version, which is Elementor 2.0, but I will also recommend you to install the premium version as well. Now I'll do both. You can just, you're fine with the Elementor simple version. The free version is also fine, but the pro version is very cheap. And you know, in terms of price, it is very low priced. And the features that you get is really amazing. So you can use both the free version, but I would recommend you to use both the free and the premium plugin. So if you want the premium plugin, open a new tab and type in blogdude.com/elementor. Now this link is also given in the video description below. You can just click on that link and you will be redirected to this page. Now you'll see all the premium module that you get with this one, because in the free Elementor plugin you get a very limited module, but here you have very premium modules like animated headline. For example, this animated headline, you will get this only in the premium version of Elementor, not in the free version. You get a simple headline in the free version, but not the animated headline. Okay, and many different modules like form. If you want to create a form, you can create using the pro version. You can create price tables using the pro version, and there are many different elements over here. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to go at the bottom and you'll see the price section over here. Let me see, here it is. We have three different packages. The first one is a very nicely priced, I would say only $49 for one website. So if you're planning to use Elementor Pro only on one website, then you're totally fine with the personal plan, with this plan. But if you're a freelancer like me, if you're a person who creates website for different clients, then this is the perfect package for you. $199 unlimited. So here you can use Elementor Pro on unlimited number of websites. So you can use the Pro version on all your clients' website, or all your friends' website, everything. You can use them on unlimited number of websites. So for people who are creating a website only for their business, they are not going to create any website in the future, then they can select the personal one. Or if you want to create a website, and if you want to use Elementor Pro on unlimited number of websites, on all the websites that you're going to create, then you can select this version. Okay, now I won't be purchasing this because I have already done that. I already have purchased the premium plugin. So once you purchase the premium plugin, it's time to download the plugin. So let me show you how you can download and activate it. First, click on this link which says account, and you'll see this thing over here. Okay, you have the license key over here. And it's, as you can see, active install is one website, but here you'll see zero if you're seeing this for the first time. And what you have to do, you have to click on this button which says view websites. Okay, before that, first we have to install the theme. So again, come back, click on this button which says download plugin. So it will download the premium plugin for you. Okay, now as you can see, the premium plugin is getting downloaded. So it is successfully downloaded. Once you download the theme, once you download the plugin, you can click on this link which says visit websites. And here you have to enter the website on which you want to activate the plugin. So I have already entered and activated it. Just enter the website and it will be activated. Now copy the license key from here. Just copy it from here. Come back to your website. In fact, come back to your website dashboard. First, let's install the premium plugin. So click on this add new plugin button. Now click on upload plugin, choose file and choose that file. So this is the premium plugin file. Select this, click on open, click on install now. Now click on activate plugin. Okay guys, so as you can see, the plugin is installed and activated, but before that we'll have to activate the license. So click on this activate license button and enter your license key over here. Click on activate. Okay, now as you can see, the status is active. So your plugin is now active on your website. Now we can use Elementor Pro on our website, which is really amazing. So let's see how to get started. First thing that we have to do, we have to create a page. Okay, because as you can see, this is a simple page, our home page. So let's first create the home page and start creating this website. Okay, so come back to this dashboard and from the left hand side hover over pages and click on add new. Now it's time to give a title to this page. So because it is our home page, let's name it home page. Okay, and click on publish. Now we can just view this page in a new tab. So let's open this link in a new tab. Okay, so this is how your page is looking, but we want a very simple page. Why? Because here, if you see, we have a navbar and it is white color. We don't want a white color navbar. We want a transparent navbar. Also, we don't want this sidebar, and we also don't want the page title and breadcrumbs. Now, the reason I made you choose the OceanWP free plugin is because of all these things. Because in this theme, the OceanWP theme, although this theme is a free theme, but you get many premium options. Like, you can change all these things from here, from your page. So come back to your page, on this page, the home page, and scroll down. Now here at the bottom, you'll see OceanWP settings. The first one is the main setting, the content layout. So from the content layout, you have different options. Select the full width option. Okay, and we don't want the margins, so just disable margins. Okay, so the content layout will be full width and margins will be disabled. Now also, as I said, we want transparent menu, and we don't want the heading, and we also don't want the breadcrumb. So let's see. The next option is header. So click on header. We don't want to display any top bar, as you can see. And I don't know if you could see, but there is a very thin line over here, and after that, above that, there is that section is called top bar. We don't want that, so we'll just disable the top bar, and the header style will select transparent. Now after that, we have the title. We don't want the title, so we'll just disable it, and we also don't want the breadcrumb, so we'll select breadcrumb and click on disable. This is what breadcrumb is. Okay, as you can see, this is the breadcrumb. So once you do all these settings, click on the update button, come back to your website, and let's refresh it. Now, as you can see, everything is gone. Now you're seeing a blank page. Now at first it is looking terrible, but don't worry, we'll make it exactly like this website. Okay, so let's start doing that. So to do so, we'll be using Elementor, as you know. So click on this button which says edit with Elementor. Okay guys, so as I said you earlier, we'll be using blocks to create our website. Now the reason is very simple, that will save a lot of time, and it is the blocks which are created by really expert people. So why is it important to be created by expert people? Because they know what should be the size of your font, or the size of the margin. For example, what should be the margin top, what should be the padding, how much gap there should be there on your website, and all those things are decided by expert people. So they have created blocks, so we don't have to do anything. We just have to install all the blocks one by one according to the demo website, and after we are done with the homepage blocks, we'll start designing them. So let's see how to do that. I know it might sound a little bit confusing, but let me show you. It is really, really easy. So to install or to add a block, just click on this button which says add template. Now from here, you'll see this blocks, click on that. Now if you see over here, there are few blocks which are free, but there are few which are only available for the premium version or the pro version. For example, if you see this one, this is free, but if you see this one here, it says pro. So this is available only for Elementor Pro. So if you're using the free version, you can select only the one which is available for free. But if you're using the pro version, you can use any one of this. Okay, so the first section is this section, and here we have the hero image, the background image. We have a full width background image. So this section is called hero section. Okay, so from the category, we'll select hero. Let's search over here. Here it is, hero. And the section, the design that we have selected, let's see that design. Now, as you can see, this is the design that I have selected. Okay, now I know it is looking totally different. Okay, but this is the one which I have selected. So hover here and you'll see this insert button, click on that. Okay guys, so this is how it is. Now I know it is looking different. If you see my website, we have a beautiful image in the background, but the main structure is same. For example, if you see, we have this animated headline, we have the sub headline, and we have the button, and we have a background image. Now here also we have animated headline, sub headline, call to action button, and a background image. Okay, so first we will create only the structure, and after that we'll see how to design it. So first, if you see one thing, if you want to see how this will look on a live website, then what you can do, you can click on this button, Now this is how it will look on your website. Now this is not looking good because the image stops over here. We have some margin from both the side. We don't want any margin. We want full width. As you can see on our demo website, we have this image as full width. So let's do that. Now again, come back over here, and at the top, if you see when you hover this at the top, we have these blue things, different icons over here. Click on it. You'll see different options now. Now we don't have to do much now. First, we'll just make it full width. So here you have this stretch section location. Just make it yes. Now if you see, this is full width. This section is stretched. Okay. So this is what, this is our first block. Now after that, we have this our services block. So let's grab this one again. Click on add template. Now instead of hero, select services. And you have again many different designs for services. Now the one which we have used is this one, image services, because if you see, we have the image over here and we have the same design like this one. So select this, hover this and click on insert. Okay, so as you can see, we have the second one as well, and it is looking very much similar, but the design is totally different. We'll see how to design that later on. First, we'll add all the different sections and at the end, we'll design it. Let's make this full width as well. So again, hover this, click on this blue section, edit section, stretch section, fine. And after that, we have this stat section, okay, stat block. So again, scroll down, click on add template. Now instead of services, select stats. And the one which we have used is this one, as you can see. Alternate numbers and all these things. So this is the one which we have used. So hover this and click on insert. Okay, we have very similar one. Now let's make this full width as well. After that, we have this feature section. So let's grab that, click on add template. Instead of stats, let's select features. So here it is, select this one. Now again, we have different styles, very beautiful styles for features. But the one which I have used is this one, the last one. So hover this, click on insert. Okay, so this is how it is looking. Now let's make this full width as well. Okay, now it is not looking good at present. I know it is just some black and white website and this would look really terrible. But I'll show you how you can, you know, improve the design. We'll see that thing, don't worry. Okay, after this, we have this section, the portfolio section. Let's see how to do that. Again, click on add template. Instead of features, let's select portfolio and let's select this one. Okay, this two rows, six images over here. Select this one, click on insert. Okay, again, let's click on over here, edit section, let's stretch section. Now still it is not looking like this. Here we don't have any gap and everything is full width. But here we have a lot of gap and it is not full width, but we'll see how to do these things. Okay, don't worry. After that, we have this section, which is the map section. So again, scroll down, click on add template and let's select the contact section. Here it is, contact. Now here at the left hand side, we have this simple form, contact us form. At the right hand side, we have this beautiful map. So let's select that one. Here we have at the first one is the one which we are using, and this is a pro element, so it is available only if you're using Elementor Pro. So select this one, click on insert. Okay, we at the left hand side we have this section, at the right hand side we have this section. Let's make it full width, and after that we have the arc line section. So again, scroll down, click on add template, select clients from here. And the one which I have used, I guess, is this one. Okay, select this one, click on insert. Okay, yeah, this is the one. And like always, let's make it full width. Now the last section or the last block is this block, call to action block. So again, come back over here, click on add template and select call to action. Now here again, we have many different options over here, but the one which I have used is this one, very simple one. Select this, click on insert. Okay, we have this one. Let's make it full width. Select this and make it full width. Okay guys, so you can see within few minutes, within 2-3 minutes, we have this structure ready for our website. Okay, now this is really crazy. If you're using WordPress for a long time, you know that this thing was impossible before, you know, 2-3 years ago, I don't know, maybe 4 years ago. But now creating a website has become so simple. And as I said you earlier, these designs are created by professionals. As I said you earlier, if you have a very nice amount of gap, okay? Now, when a new person who doesn't know about web designing creates a website, it becomes very difficult for him to decide the size of the icon, the amount of gap and padding and so on. But because, as I said you earlier, this is created by experts, you can see the amount of gap and everything is just perfect. Okay, everything is just perfect over here. We just have to design it according to our needs. So I'll show you how to do that. First, let's update the page. So click on this button which says update. And if you want to see how this will look, you know, on your website, you have this eye icon over here. Preview changes, click on that button. A new link will open. Okay, so this is how your website is looking at present. This is your page. Now let's start designing the website. Okay, so to do so, again, come back to this page. Now let's start designing the first section. Okay, so first let's change the background image. So to do so, as you can see, this is the background image to the complete section. So we'll select this option at the top which says edit section, click on that, and we have all the options over here. Okay, we have the content width at present is boxed, and I would recommend you to make this and to keep this as boxed. Now don't mess up with any one of the layout setting, just make or leave this as it is. Just go to the design section. Okay, now if you see the background color is given black, we don't want that. Just select this and click on clear. It will clear this color. And if you see this image, this is the image which is used over here, but we want a beautiful image like this which is used on our demo website. Now this image or whatever image I have used in my website, in the demo website, I am giving these things for free. You will see a link in the video description below. Open that link and you can download all the images for free. Okay, so let's change this image. Let's delete it and click on this plus button to add a new one. Click on select files, and this is the file, all the files which will be requiring in this video. So all these images which you see over here are given to you for free. So you'll see a link in the video description below. Click on that link and you can download everything which you see over here for free. Now, so this is the image that we have used in the demo website. So select this one, click on open. Okay, so we have this image over here. Select that, click on insert media. Now, as you can see, we have the image in the background. But if you notice one thing, this image is looking really dark. But here, the image looks really fine. It is not looking dark. Now, that is because we have something which is overlay used over here. But before we go that, let's see some other settings. Now the position, make sure it is center. Attachment, make sure it is default, which is fine. Repeat, also it is default. Size, cover, which is everything is fine. Now here we have background overlay. And here if you see, the black color is selected. Now you can select different color as well. For example, you can select blue. Now you can see blue overlay. And you can also change the transparency. As you can see here, we have two bars over here. This is the first one. This is the second one. The second one is for transparency. If I decrease that, you can see the transparency decreases. And you can change the color over here. As you can see, the changes on your screen when I change the color. But in this in the demo website, we have not used the overlay. So you can just click on this clear button and it will clear all the overlay. Now as you can see, this is looking really amazing. Okay, now after that, we have everything is fine. We are not using any border or shape divider at present. We'll be using all these things, all these options later on. So don't worry, we will not leave anything untouched. Okay, we'll see everything. We'll use all the options, the shape divider, the border, the typography, everything. But here in this section, we don't require all these things. So we can just leave it. Okay, now let's change this thing. Okay, the heading, we want to change the design, the animation, and we also want to change the text. So to do any changes, just click on that heading. Okay, when you click on that heading, at the left hand side, you will see all the settings related to that heading. Now the first thing that we have to do, we have to change the text. Here the text is, as you can see, design, fashion, realism, modern. And here our text is how to make a website with WordPress using Elementor 2, whatever you want to make your text or whatever you want to put over there. Okay, So what you can do, you can select everything and delete it. Now let's put in our own text, how to make a website. Okay, this is my first text. And if you want to add another text, just press enter it and go to next line and enter the next text. And let's may enter using WordPress. Okay, so we have two things. And again, to enter the next one, press enter and let's type in with Elementor version 2.0. Okay, so we have three different text over here. Obviously, you can increase or decrease this number. It's all up to you. Also, if you notice one thing, the design or the animation is very boring, and here the animation is very nice. It is the typing animation which is used in the demo website. So let's change this thing, come back over here. At the top you have this style, and by default rotating is selected, and the rotating one should be selected. Okay, the next option is animation, select that, and let's select the first one which is typing. Now as you can see, the typing animation is selected, and you can see the typing animation is going on. You have some more option like blinds. If you select blind, this is the animation which you see on your screen. This is also looking very nice. You have some more like wave. Now this is the animation for wave which you see on your screen. Wow, this is also nice. We have many beautiful animations over here, but the one which I want to use is typing. So select typing. Rest everything is fine. Now go to style, because if you see over here, the text is different. The style, the font style is totally different. Okay, and here it is very boring, very simple font style. So let's change that. So here we have the heading option. To change the style, you have the typography option over here. Click on this pencil button. The font family which we have used in our demo website is Atma, ATMA. Type ATMA and you'll see this option over here. Select Atma from here. Now all the fonts should be changed, but I don't see that happening. Let's try again. Okay, let's click on this thing again. Select this. Let's change. Okay, the size is getting changed, but let's select some different font. Let's select maybe blue. Yeah, the font is changing. So let's try again. Okay, let's click on this pencil button, select this and type in Atma, ATMA, select that. Okay, I don't know why. Freaking. Now also, if you notice the font, this font style which we have used in the demo website is totally different than this one. So let's change that. To change this thing, just click on this pencil button and from here select any font that you like. Okay, there are hundreds of different fonts over here. You can select any one of these and it will be applied. As you can see, when I change the font, you will see the font changes over here. Now the one which we have used is called Atma. So search for Atma, select that one. Okay, I see that no changes are taking place. So what we can do is we can again click on this pencil button and we can change the primary font instead of that. Okay, in fact, that is more recommended, because if we use this typography method, we'll have to change the font style again and again. But we, if you use the primary font method, all the fonts which you see will be changed at once. Okay, so let's see how to do that. So what you can do, you can click on over here, this hamburger icon which you see, my cursor, click on that icon. Now we have default colors, default fonts, so select the default fonts, select the primary header, and instead of Roboto, select Atma, search for ATMA Atma, and now as you can see, the font has changed. Now the font has not only changed from here, if you see all the fonts, like as you see services, you see alternate number, all the fonts that we are using on our website, all the fonts are changed. So this saves a lot of time. Okay, so we are done with this thing. Click on apply. Okay, now the font is changed. Now it's time to change the color and the design of this button. As you can see, the design of this button is very boring, but the design of this one is really nice. So what you can do to change the design of the button, simply click on that button. Now the first thing that we have to change is the text. Here it says read more, but in the demo website it says learn more. So let's put learn more instead of read more. Fine, so now it says learn more. Now go to style to change the design, and first thing is typography. Select this one. You can change any typography from here. For example, for this also you can put Atma. Now as you can see, when I put Atma, the style of the button changes. But for this one, I don't recommend Atma. What you can do, you can select either fonts like Roboto or Poppins. Poppins is a very nice font which I use, so I'm selecting Poppins, P-O-P-P-I-N-S. So select that, and this is how it will look. Now here, if you see, everything is uppercase, which is capital letters. So if you want to make this thing as uppercase as well, what you can do, you can select the transform option and select uppercase. Now as you can see, everything is uppercase. Now the weight is 600, so what I want to decrease that to 400. Now this looks much better, the font is looking much better. And let's increase some spacing between the letter. As you can see, it is really hard to read that, but when I increase the space between the letter, this is how it will look. So let's make it something like this. 1.5 is looking much better. Okay, so you can change more things like this, style, decoration and everything, but this is it for now. We can just deselect this one. Now the text color is white, which is fine, but the background color over here is, you know, colorless. We have a transparent background color, but here we have this beautiful background color. So let's see what this color is. Now let me show you a very simple and a very useful technique. If you wanna know what this color is, what you can do, you can hover this button, right click over here, select inspect. Now once you do so, at the left hand side, you will see this section, and here we have the color. It is 10C5A7. So copy this color code and you can just cut this thing now. Come back over here, and here we have the background color option. Select that and paste in this color code. Now as you can see, this is looking exactly like that one. Okay, now but when I hover this, the background color remains same and the text color becomes green, which is looking very, very bad. But here when I hover this, the background color becomes pink and the text color remains white. Okay, so let's see what this pink color is. Again, do the same technique, hover that, right click and select inspect element. Now you have this background color over here. It is FF7A7A, select that. Come back over here. Now if you want to change the hover style, what you can do is, now at present it is on normal and here we have hover option, click on that. Now we have the text option. So on hover, we want the text color to remain white, and the border color we want white, and background color we want this color. Okay, now let's see. Now as you can see, when I hover this, the background color changes and the text color also changes and it remains white. So this is looking nice. Now let's see some more changes. If you see over here, this is not a rectangle button. We have some rounded corners over here. So let's make these corners rounded. Over here, if you see the border radius, if you increase this radius, the corners will get rounded. If you increase it to something like 100, it will become something like this. Okay, but this is not 100 here. We have a very simple or very small roundation. So we'll see, we'll make it maybe 20. Not even 20, I think let's make it 5. Okay, so 5 is looking better. And I also noticed one thing, that the space at the left hand side and right hand side is not very much. But here we have a lot of space at the left and right. So let's decrease that. At the bottom you'll see padding. Now that is what a space is. Okay, so right and left padding is 40. Let's make it 35. So let's make left and right padding as 35. Okay, so with this we complete the first section. As you can see guys, within few minutes we have completed a complete section. Okay, if you want to change this subtitle, what you can do, you can just simply click on over here and you can change the text from here. Okay, once you are done with all these settings, just click on update. Now once you update, the page over here will also be updated. So let's reload this one. Okay, now as you can see, this is how our website is looking at present. This is the top section. This is looking amazing. Now let's change this section. Okay, the second section. So let's scroll down. First thing is to change the color and the text. Here it says services, and in the demo website it says our services, and after that we have a subtitle and also divider, but here we don't have any subtitle and divider. So let's do that. First let's make it our services. So click on services. At the left hand side you will see these options. Now let's type in our services over here. exactly like this one. Now go to style. Let's change this color. This is complete black. We don't want that. Now here if you see the default color, the second color besides the blue, select that one. Okay. Also the weight of this font is a lot, and here the weight is very decent weight. It is not that bold, but this one is a very bolder. Okay. So what you can do if you want to change that, we have this typography option. Click on this pencil button, and the weight is 900. Let's make it 600. Yeah. Now it is looking much better. Okay. Now after this, we have this subtitle. So let's add this subtitle. So what you can do, you can click on this link over here, or this logo at the top right logo. As you can see, this dot dot logo, click on that. And here we have the heading element. Now you can drag this heading element below this title. Okay. Now here we have the heading element, and here it says lorem ipsum, some dummy text. So what I'll do, I'll just copy this text from here and paste it over here. Now here it says lorem ipsum. Now, because it is center aligned, what I'll do, I'll make it center aligned. At the bottom, you'll see alignment. Here it is this center option. Select center align. Go to style. First, let's change the color. This is blue color. Let's make it this same color, dark gray color. And also change the style. As you can see, this style is very simple and very nice one. So let's change the style. So select typography. In the font family, search for Poppins. And let's decrease the weight to maybe 400. Let's select 400. Yeah, 400 is looking nice. Okay, so this is now looking nice. And after that, we have this beautiful divider over here. Let's put that divider, because this divider really increases and beautifies the website. So let's put that divider. Again, click on this icon, and here you'll see the divider element. Drag this divider below this subtitle. Okay, here we have. Now this divider at present is looking very boring. So let's change the style. First thing is to change the weight. So let's make it to 4. Okay. Or maybe 3. It's all up to you. Okay. I'm putting 3. Let's change the color to something like this. Yeah. This is looking better. Okay. It's a darker shade. And let's change the width to maybe... Okay, this is percentage, so let's make it 15%. Let's put 15% over here, and let's make it center align. Okay, now it's looking really awesome. Now click on this update button to update the changes that we have done. Now if you notice one thing, after this we have these icons. Okay, now as I have promised you earlier while we were seeing the demo website, I'll show you how to create these icons. So let me show you what you can do. Open a new tab and type in flaticon.com. Okay, so this is a free website. You can create free icons. You don't even have to create icon. You have many pre-made icons. So here you just have to change the style and install it for you. Okay, for example, the icon which we are using will be available over here in the business one. So select this business section. But here, if you see one thing, it is simple, very simple icons. We have only the outlines. And here we have some colorful thing. Okay, as you can see, we have some colorful thing over here. So when you scroll down, you have this section. Here it is, business one. Click on this one. Now this is the icon that we have used. If you notice over here, this icon and this icon is same. Okay, there are many different icons. It's all up to you. You can use any one of these. Now I want to use this one. So what I'll do, I'll hover this and click on this eye icon. Select this. Okay, so this is how it is looking. Now I want to change the color. I want to make it something like this, exactly like my demo website. Okay, the color which I have selected over here, which is pink and greenish type of color. So let me do that. First, what I'll do, I'll click on this button which says edit icon. Okay, so first we have to log in or register to edit it. So I'll log in. Okay, let me log in with Google. Okay, again, select this one. Click on edit icon. Now let me see what are the different colors that are used, and let me do one thing. I don't have to do it again and again. What I'll do is I'll copy both these things. So first let me copy this, open a new tab, paste it over here. Okay, so I'll paste it in the Google section, and let me search first the other color. Okay, let me select this. Okay, this is the other colors. Let me copy this. Okay, so these are the two colors that we'll be using. The first one is this reddish kind of color, and the second one is this pink color. Okay, so we can use this thing again and again. We don't have to inspect element again and again. Okay, first let's change the color of this one. So select this and let's make it okay, let's see. Over here the color of that is reddish, so let's select the first one, copy it from here. Okay, now here we have the color code, so don't copy this hashtag, just copy the code after that, that 6-digit code. Copy that thing, it is F75B5B. Okay, copy that, come over here, instead of this one, delete it and paste in our color. Now as you can see, the color has changed. Now let's also change the color of this graph. So select this graph, again come back over here. Now let's select the second one, 10C5A7. Copy it, come back again, and instead of this, paste it over here. Now as you can see, we have the exact same thing that we have over here. Fine. Now what you can do is we can download this thing. So click on download button, select PNG. Now select 256 pixels. Now as you can see, the image is downloaded. Okay, so we can use this image now. And similarly, you can create icons like this very, very easily. Okay, I think it is really, really easy to create something like this. So let's get rid of this now. Come back over here. Let's change this icon. So to do so, click on that icon. Here we have, let's delete it. Click on plus button, upload files, select files. Here we have all the three. Let me select three, click on open. Okay, this was the one. Select this, click on insert media. Now we have the icon over here. Okay, now similarly, let's change this icon. Select this, delete this image, click on plus, and this is the rocket icon. Select this one, click on insert media. Now the third one, let's select this one, click on insert media. Okay, so we have our icons over here. Now if you want to change this text, you can change it easily. Okay, here we have the management text, for example. Let's again click on the first one. So we have changed the icon. After that, we have the title and description. Here as you can see, it says marketing. Now instead of marketing, suppose you want to say technology, so you can just type in technology over here. Okay, now we have technology. And after that, you can also change this text. Okay, it's all up to you. So let me delete this text and let me put it Lorem Ipsum again. Okay, so we have changed this text as well. And after that, what we can do is we can change the color. As I said you earlier, the color of this is not the dark black. We want to change this color. Okay, so what you can do is again select this style, and if you want to increase the size of this icon, here we have the image size. You can increase it and you can make it anything you want. Okay, but I don't want to do that. I think it was fine, which is I think it was 20. So I think 20 is looking fine. Okay, but you can increase or decrease it. It's all up to you. And you can also change the animation. For example, when I hover this icon, as you can see, it increases. So that is what the grow animation is. We have some more, like, you know, we have this pop one. So let's see. Okay, so as you can see, this is how the animation is. We also have something like float. Let's select float. Now as you can see, the animation has changed. We have many others, like we have let's see, we have buzz. Let's select the buzz one. Now as you can see, when I hover this icon, the animation changes. So it's all up to you. I think the grow one is a better one, very simple one, so I'll keep it to grow. Then after that, we have content. The thing which we have to change from here is the color of this technology. So I don't want the black color, I want this color, dark gray color. So I'll select this one. Also, I want to change the color of the subtitle. It is very light. I can just barely see that. So I can change that color and I'll make it dark gray again. Now this is looking much, much better. Okay, so this is how you change all these things. Now let's change the style of this button. Okay, as you can see, the style of this button is very nice. We have this pink color. When you hover this, the color changes, the text remains same. So let's change that, click on this. Okay, you can change the text, but we don't have to change it because here also it says read more. Here also it says read more. Go to style and background color. Let's select this color. Okay, the first one, and let's paste it over here. Okay, looking better. and let's select the hover color. So click on hover. Now let's select the second color code, copy it from here, and instead of this background color, paste it over here. Now as you can see, when I hover this, this is what happens. Okay, so this is looking really, really amazing. Now one more thing is left. If you notice one thing, when I hover this section, for if you see in the demo website, when I hover this column, the background has a border, and that border color is this pink color. But when I hover this, the border color is green. If you cannot see that, what you can do, you can upload or you can update this page, and you can preview this page. For example, it will show the preview over here. Now if you, I think you will see much better. When I hover this, you see this green border. We don't want the green border, we want the pink border. So what I can do now, this time, because we have to make a change in the column, because this is entire column as you can see. So what you can do, we can hover here, and here we have the column option, this gray options over here. And when I hover this, it says edit column. So click on that. Now go to style, border, and select the hover state, because when I hover this, then the border color changes. Now you'll see this green color over here. Change this green color and put the first color code, the pink one. So let's change and make it pink. Now as you can see, when I hover this, it becomes pink. Let's update this page. Come back to this page, it is loading. Let's see. Okay, now the when we hover this, we get this beautiful pink color. So similarly, you can change the button style and all these things for this as well. Or what you can do is, you can just delete this button. You can hover this, remove this widget, and you can copy this button two times. Let me show you duplicate widget. Now grab this thing over here. Okay, just like this. Now grab this button over here, just like this. Okay, so this thing really saves a lot of time. You don't have to do this thing again and again. You just do it once and you copy it and just drag it here and there, because as I said you earlier, it is just drag and drop, nothing more. Okay, after that we have the third section. Now this is also a very beautiful section. Let's see how to make some changes over here. So again, come back over here, let's scroll down. Now the first thing that we have to change over here is the background color. We have a very beautiful background color. Let's do that. So what you can do, you can hover this and select this option which says edit section. So click on edit section and go to design or go to style, and here we have the background color. Select the first option, classic option, and everything will become black by default. But what you can do, we can copy this code from here, come back over here, and let's change this color to this one. Now this is looking much better. Now let's change the color of the text to white, all this the thing to white. So let's do that. Select this one, alternate numbers. You can change the thing from here instead of alternate numbers. If you want this to say Nayar Sheikh, you can just type in Nayar Sheikh, just like this. Okay, so we have this thing changed. Now go to style, text color, make it white. Okay, this is looking better. And after that, we have this text as well at the top, our about. So select this one, go to style again, text color, make it white. Also, we have to change the typography. So select typography. Let's change the font family to Atma. Let's change the or increase the size to maybe 20, make it 20. Also increase the weight to 600. Okay, looking much better. If you also notice, we have this thing at the bottom, the divider. Okay, here it is. I don't know if you can see, because the color of the divider is also green, the background color is also green, so that's why it is difficult to see. But if you hover this, you'll see this blue section. So click on that. Now here it is, the color is this, but we want the white color. So select white color from here, and we want to increase the width to maybe 30. So let's make it 30, and this is looking better. And let's make the weight 3. Okay, fine. So this is looking much better now. Now let's change the color of all these things, all these numbers, all this percentage and text. Let's see how to change the percentage, the text, and also how to design it. Okay, so click on this number. Now here, if you see over here, the starting number is 1 and the ending number. So by default here it is 85. So suppose instead of 85, you want 73. So just type in 73. Now as you can see, it will stop at 73%. And instead of support, suppose you want to say maybe design, so you can just type in design over here. Now as you can see, it says design and it says 73. Okay, now what you can do, we can go to design or the style thing, and the text color, let's make it white, and also the text color for the title. Okay, select this and make this thing white as well. Now we have the design 73%. Okay, similarly we can do for this one, select this, the second one, instead of 74, let's make it 85. Okay, again design, let's make it white, title, make it white, select the third one. We don't have to change the percentage over here, it's fine. Go to style, change the color to white, and change the title color to white as well. Okay, looking better. Now one more thing is left. If you see over here, we have this white color, a white border color, but here we have the green border color, which is not looking nice. So let's change that. Again, we have to do the changes in the column. So how about this green section which says edit column, click on that, go to design, and go to border, and here we have this green, select this green, make it white. Similarly for this column, how about this, click on edit column, style, border, change this to white, and also for the third one, style, border, color white. Okay, now click on update. Now if you see, this page is getting loaded. Let's see. Okay, so this is looking amazing. Now let's see how to change this section. Okay, here we have to increase the size of the icon, change the color of the icon, and we also have to change this image. So let's do that. Let's first change this image. So click on this image. Now let's delete this, click on plus button, click on upload, select files, and select this one, select this file which says galleries, and click on open, insert media. Okay, so we have this image over here. Now again, if you see over here, the color is totally different. The color is this dark gray, and the style of this font is also different. Rest everything is fine. So again, select this font. If you want to change this thing, for example, here it says features to start. If you want to change this thing to something, you can change it. Okay, you can just delete it from here and type in anything like you want. Okay, now go to style. Select the color and select the second one, the dark gray color. Now select this R gallery section, go to style, let's make it a dark gray color, select the typography, let's change the font family to Atma, the font size to 20, font weight to 600. Okay, looking much better. Now select this thing, the icon one, and we have to increase the size of the icon, and we also have to change the color of the icon. So the color is this one, so let's copy it from here, come over here, and here we have the icon. If you want to change this icon, if you want instead of this pencil, if you want something, you can just search for it. For example, if you want car, you can just search for car. You can, or if you want, you can search for something like trophy. You can search for anything you want. Okay, so we have this trophy over here, but because here in the demo website we have used pencil, so let's stick with pencil. So search for pencil icon, here it is, select it, and you can also change this text from here, and instead of design, if you want to say something else, you can change it from here. For example, instead of design, you can change this to maybe SEO, you can select SEO. Now go to style, the primary color of the icon. Now this is what we have to change, and put in this color. Now as you can see, the icon color is changed. Now let's increase the size of the icon and let's make it something like this, because I think this is looking much better. So come over here, and here we have the size. Let's increase this and let's make it to something like this. I think 60 is looking better. 60 pixels is looking better. Now you can also have some hover effect, for example, icon hover, and you can have some animation like maybe something like grow. Now as you can see, when I hover this icon, it grows. Now here we don't have any hover effects, but I was just showing you that you can use something like this. And let's change the color and everything of this content, this title and everything. So select this content, select this color, instead of black, let's make it dark gray. And also the description, instead of this light color, select it dark gray. this is looking much better. And I just noticed one more thing, that here we have this divider, but here we don't have it. Now we don't have to create the divider again and again. What we can do is, we can come over here and we can save this divider as our global element. So what you can do, we can hover over here, click on this pencil button, or hover over this pencil button. You'll see this option which says save widget. Click on that option. You can name it anything. So let's make it or let's name it divider. Click on save. Okay, so as you can see, this divider is saved as the global element. So let's scroll down, and if you want to use this divider over here, go to global. You'll see this divider, drag it over here. Okay, so we have the divider over here. First thing that we have to do is unlink. Okay, and after that we can edit it. For example, instead of 15, let's make it 30. Okay, and instead of center align, let's make it left align, looking much better. Okay, so this is how you do it. Now similarly, you can change the color of this icon and all the text from here. After that, we have this section. Okay, this section, this gallery or the portfolio section. The first thing is that if you notice one thing, the background color of this complete section is totally different. It's not white, it is something like light gray. So let's do that. Come back over here, hover over this and click on this edit edit section. Go to style and select this background color, select color, and select any light gray color. So what you can do, or you can just type in some code if you have, like F7 is also a light color. Or what you can do, you can select some color from here, whatever you like, you can just select it from here. So I am selecting ED. Okay, so this is how it is looking. We have white and we have this color. Now let's change the color of this section or this title. Check out our work. So select this thing, and obviously you can change the title from here. Instead of check out our work, you can change it to maybe check out our portfolio if you want. Okay, I'm just showing you that you can change it from here. Okay, now go to style, change this color to dark gray. Fine. Okay, just like this one. Now go to the second one, the subheading. Go to style, change this color to dark gray again. Go to typography and let's make it Poppins. Let's increase the size to 20 pixels and the weight to 400. Okay, looking much better. Now again, we have this divider over here. So what you can do, we can again go back over here, click on this global element. We have this divider, drag it or bring it over here. Okay, now we don't have to do any changes over here, so it's all right. Now click on this image. Now as you can see, this is using image gallery. So what you can do is, we can just delete all these images from here. Here you have the clear option. Click on clear, make it delete. Now let's add our images. Click on add images, upload files, select files, and select all these files. All these files are given to you for free. You'll see a link in the video description below. Click on that link and you can download all these images for free. Okay, so select all these images, gallery 1, gallery 2 till gallery 6. Click on open. Fine, now click on create a new gallery. Click on insert gallery. Okay, so we have this thing something like this. Now this still looks totally different from this one. Here we don't have any gap and it is all full width. So let's do that. Come back over here. So what you can do is, you can click on this edit section, and content width, you can select full width. Okay, now as you can see, everything is full width, but we still have some gap between the images. So what you can do, okay, here no gap is selected, but we still have some gap. So what you can do is, we can come over here, select this section. Okay, make sure it is image size full, column 3. Okay, come to style, and here we have this spacing. Okay, by default it is 10, make it 0. Okay, now this should look exactly like the demo website. Let's see, let's update this page. Come back to this page, it is automatically reloading. Let's scroll down. Now as you can see, this is looking exactly like the demo website, except that we have some space over here. Here, as you can see, we have some space. Let's delete this thing. Okay, this is the thing that we have to get rid of. Now select this edit section, go to advanced, and here if you see in the bottom padding we have this 100. Let's make it 0. Now as you can see, that thing is gone. Now again, let's scroll down. Now as you can see, I know you guys are noticing that it is really, really easy to create a website with this. You have this structure ready for you. You just have to change this style according to you, and changing the style also, it is really easy. So I hope you guys are learning something. You guys are learning how to create a website really fast, because in today's world, if you're watching this video to create your own website, or if you want to create a website for your friend, for some family member, or if you're a freelancer or a web designer, and if you it is really crucial today to create a website, design a professional website in a very short period of time. So this tool really helps it out. Okay, so it is really easy to create a professional design and in a very short period of time. So let's see how to do that. Now, so let's select this title, go to style, let's change this to dark gray. Select this subtitle, go to style, let's change this to dark gray as well. Change the typography, family should be Poppins. Okay, let's change the size to 20 and the weight to 400, looking better. Now we have the contact form. So what you can do, you can click on that contact form, and you have three different options over here, like name, email and message. Now if you want, you can add some new item or you can delete some item. For example, if you don't want this name, you can just delete it. Now as you can see, we have only email and message, but I think we need that. So if you want to do undo some change, what you can do, you can just press Ctrl Z and you have that name thing again over here. Okay, now let's change some general settings. So what you can do, click on name and select type as text, label as name, and placeholder. Now as you can see, the placeholder is this. Under that you see Bobby D, that is the placeholder. You can change this thing and put something like this, like, you know, enter your name here. So enter your name here, so you're saying the user to enter the name over here. Now after that, what you can do, if you want to make this thing required, you can make this thing yes. You can change the width, this is 100%, which is fine. If you want, you can make it 50%, 40%, it's all up to you. Okay, but I think 100% is better, because that is what we have in the demo website. Now after that, we have the email section, select the second one. And again, instead of this placeholder, you can type something like enter your email here. Okay, and make sure the type is selected as email. Now why is it important to select the type? Now because when someone tries to enter something, and if they leave it like this, and when they click on the send message, okay, as you can see, this is giving an error that this is not the email format. So this thing should look like an email format, like something at the rate of something.com. Okay, so it should look something like that. Okay, and if you want to make it required, obviously you have to make it required. Make sure to make this thing yes. After you do all these changes, you have this submit button option. Click on that. Let's change the submit style. Okay, if you see over here, the normal color is this, and when we hover over this, it becomes pink. So let's do that. Okay, first we have to do some other changes, like instead of this text, send message. If you want, you can change it. After that, we have action after submit. So select that and make sure email is there. Now, because we are using the blocks, everything is over here at present automatically. So what happens after you submit? So you send an email. Okay, you send all the details to somewhere. Now let's see where all the details are going. So select this email section. Okay, now here, instead of this email address, put in your own email address. Okay, so I'm putting my email address over here. Okay, now this is the email where you'll get all these options. Okay, where whenever someone fills in this form, click on this send button, all this information will be sent on this email. So make sure you put in your email address over here. Okay, and in the from email address, you can change it or you can just leave it just like this. Now metadata, you have some metadata. So whenever someone fills in this form and click on the send button, you'll receive these metadatas or this information, like the date, the time, the page URL, the IP address of the person, and so on. Okay, so once you're doing all this thing, click on update. Now let's change the style of this button. So go to style section, select button. Now instead of this background color, let's change this to this one. Okay, let's put it this. Okay, now as you can see, it has changed. And also let's change the hover background color to this color. Okay, so copy it and paste it over here. Now as you can see, when I hover this, this is how it is looking. Now let's change this section. Now as you can see, here we have only the map. We don't have all this thing over here. So first we have to delete it. So hover here and click on cut this thing. Okay, and also we don't want this black color background color. So what you can do, you can select this edit column, go to style, we have this color background color, select this, click on clear, we don't want that. Now click on this map. Okay, first thing is that the first thing that you have to do, you have to put in your address. So what I'll do, instead of this UK address, I will put Mumbai over here. Now as you can see, I'm getting this Mumbai map. And select the height as maybe 400 or 450. I'm selecting 450. Now go to advanced. Okay, not here. Select this column again, edit column, and go to advanced. And if you see over here, some padding is selected. That's why we have gap from all the side. We don't want any gap. We have this map something like this. So just select everything and make it zero. All padding zero, and it will look something like this. Now click on update. Okay, one more thing is left. If you see again, yeah, no, okay, fine, everything is fine. I think nothing is left. Come back to this page, let's see the changes. So this is how our website is looking at present. Everything is looking fine. We have this section as well. Now let's play around with this section, our client section. Come over here. The first thing that we have to do, we have to change the color of this background color. Okay, so let's do that. Let's hover over here and click on this edit section. Go to style, background color, and let's put the same color that we have put earlier, ED, ED, ED. Okay, so we have this background color. Now select this, the title, go to style, let's change the color to dark gray. Now select this one, the subtitle, go to style, let's change the color to dark gray. And also let's change the typography to Poppins. Okay, font size to 20 and weight to 400. Okay, looking much better. And we also have this beautiful divider. So you know how to get that. Click on this icon, go to global, select this divider, bring it over here. Okay, just below this one. Okay, maybe below this over here. Okay, so this is looking much better. Okay, but I see there is a lot of space over here between this divider and this. So let's fix that. Select this thing, the second one, the subtitle, go to advanced. And here if you see, the bottom margin is 50. Let's make it 10, or maybe let's make it 0. Okay, now this is looking much better. Fine, now click on update. Now if you want to change all these icons from here, what you can do is, you can select this thing. It is just a simple image. You can just change this, you can delete this image and upload your own image, whatever you want. Okay, for example, if you want this image, select it, click on install. Okay, so you have this thing over here. And after that, we have the last section, which is this one. Okay, so select this, click on this one. We don't have to change the background color because this is how it is, but we don't want this thing. Here we have the title and subtitle. We don't want the subtitle one. So what I'll do is, I'll delete it. I'll click on title, go to design. Okay, typography, let's make it Poppins, simple one. Let's change this to 600 width, 600 weight. Okay, looking better. Now select this button. Now what we can do, we can again go over here, because we don't want to do all these changes again. We can hover this button, click on this save widget and add this widget as button. Click on save. Now come back over here. At the bottom, delete this button and bring this button over here. Okay, now we just have to change we have to unlink it, and we just have to change the text. And instead of read more, here it says start free trial. So let's type in start free trial. And we also have to change the link. Now we will be creating the contact page very soon. After this, we'll be creating about us, then maybe the services, and after that, at the end, we'll create the contact us page. So you can put the contact page link over here after you create that page. Okay, now for now, you can just leave this thing like this. Now click on update, come back to this page. Now, as you can see, with this, we have successfully completed our home page. Now, just one simple thing is left, and that is the animations. For example, let me show you this. When we refresh our demo website, we have a lot of animations going on. Let's see. As you can see, all these are animations. As you can see, whenever I scroll, I see all these animations going on. Okay. So let's put this animation. Let's see how to put these animations. So first, let's select this header, this heading, go to advanced. And here you have entrance animation. Select that and let's select maybe slide from left, slide in left. Okay, as you can see, this is looking better. And for the second one, subheading, let's select maybe slide from left, that slide from right for this one. Okay, looking better. Select the button, go to advanced, entrance animation, and let's make it zoom in up. Okay, this is how it is. Go to click on update. Let's refresh this page. Now, as you can see, the animation over here. Okay, so similarly, you can add animation to all these things. Okay, you can add animation to each and everything, or you can add animation to a column or to a section, to a row. For example, if you want to add animation to this entire column, what you can do is select this column, edit column, go to advanced, and for this, let's make it fade in left. Okay, select this column, go to advanced, let's make it fade in right, better. Select the middle column, advanced, fade in maybe up. Okay, now we can select this title, advanced, and let's make it slide in, maybe slide in up. Yeah, slide in up for this one. Select the subtitle, advanced, entrance animation, slide in down, let's select that. Okay, here it is, slide in down. Select this one, the divider, first unlink it. Okay, now go to advanced, entrance, let's make it to bounce in up. Let's see how it looks. Okay, better. You can also change the duration. As you can see, normal, slow, fast. If you want to make it fast, you can select this, it is fast. If you want to make it slow, now, as you can see, it is quite slow. So you can change this as well. Okay, let's update and see the changes. Come back over here. Okay, you can see all these animations. Okay, looking better. So similarly, you can add animations on everything over here. Once you're done with this, what you can do is you can optimize your website for different devices. For example, we were creating a website for a desktop version, but if you want to know how your website will look in a mobile phone, what you can do, here at the bottom, you have this responsive mode. Click on that and select mobile. Okay, so this is how your website will look on a mobile phone. Okay, quite better. Okay, so you can change anything you want, but this is how it is looking on a mobile phone. I think it is looking very good. For example, if you want to change the size of this icon in a mobile phone, what you can do is select this, or maybe if you want to make it center line, you can select this, select center line. Now, as you can see, it is center line. Now, if you want to change the style or the size, go to style, and instead of 28, you can make it to maybe 20. Okay, so this is how it will look on a mobile phone, but in the on desktop, it will look exactly same. Okay, now once you're done with everything, just click on update. And with this, we have completed our home page. Okay, let's again go to desktop. Okay, so now after that, let's see what we have next. Okay, after this, we have this about us page. Let's click on about us. Okay, so this is how it is looking, about us page. Let's create this page now. Okay, before that, if you see over here, we have this client section and the bottom section used over here. So what we can do is we can save both this section. So let's do that. Now, however, this edit section, you see this save section over here, click on save section. Let's name it clients. Okay, spelling is wrong. Click on save. And similarly, let's save this section as well. Okay, as the footer section, click on save. Okay, so we have both these sections. Now we can just cut this thing. Okay, now let's add the about us page and let's create it something like this. So what you can do is we can hover this at the top, you see new, hover this and click on page. So we are adding new page. Let's add the title as about us. Okay, again come at the bottom and let's do all these changes. First, content layout, it is full width. We don't want any margin, so let's disable it. Go to header. We don't want the top bar, so let's disable it. Header style, it is transparent. After that, go to title, disable it. Breadcrumb, disable it. Now click on publish. Now click on edit with Elementor. Okay, fine. So first thing that we have over here is this section. So again, we can use simple blocks. So click on add template. Now go to blocks. Now go to services. Let's see, here it is, services, and search something like this. Okay, here we have the icons used. Okay, we are not using images this time. This time we are using icons. So you can select this one. Okay, design service, we can select this one. So select this and click on insert. Okay, so we have something like this. Okay, it is looking very much similar. We just have to design it. First thing that we have to do, we have to design it something like this. As you can see, at the top we have this background color and bottom we have this curve thing. Okay, we have to put this curve. Let's see how to do that. First, edit section, make it full width. Okay, now go to style, background type. In fact, not in the, yeah, background type, in the background overlay, select classic options and copy this code, second color code, color, and paste it over here. Now if you see over here, this is looking quite light. If you want to make it dark, you can just increase this thing from here, or if you want to make it light, you can do it from here. Okay, it's all up to you. I think this is looking better. Now once you do so, we will have to make it something like this. At the bottom, if you see, this is the curve animation, not the regular one. So what you can do, you'll see something called shape divider. Click on shape divider, and because we have to divide, change the shape of the bottom, select bottom, and in the type, select curve. Now as you can see, this curve is not the one we want. We want to change it. So here you have the invert option. Let's invert this curve. Okay, so this is how we want it. Okay, let's see. Okay, this is how we want it. This is looking better, but I think this background color is not looking better. Let's change that. Come to background overlay. Let's select a darker version, or maybe let's remove this overlay from here. Okay, go to normal background and let's upload this color. Okay, I think this is looking much better. Okay, let's see how it looks. Okay, this is how it is looking. Now what you can do is, let's again go to this section, the shape divider, bottom. Okay, here we have the width, so we can increase the width to something like 200, and when you change the height, you can see this is how it looks. So you can change it to anything you want. Okay, so let's make it maybe 450. Okay, yeah, 450 is looking better. Okay, so this is how it is looking at present. Now let's click on update. Let's click on this preview changes. It will open a new tab, and this is how our website is looking at present. Now we have to do some changes again. First thing is that we have to change this text. Okay, this one, select this one, go to style, and here instead of design services, first let's change it to about us. So let's type in about us. Now go to style, white color. Okay, and let's change the typography. Let's change the weight to maybe 600. Let's make it 600. Yeah, better. After that, we have this simple divider and simple text like this. Let's do that. Go to this, click on this icon, go to global, bring the divider over here, and let's unlink it. Okay, change the color to white, and let's decrease the size. Instead of 15, let's make it 10. And after that, we have this simple text over here at the bottom. So again, come back to this section and say, bring this heading over here. Okay, paste anything you want or type anything you want in the heading, make it center align. Go to style. First thing is that we have to change the color, so let's make it white. Okay, now let's change the font family to Poppins. Okay, better. And size to maybe 20. Okay, or maybe this time let's make it 18. Let's change the weight to 400. Okay, and yeah, rest everything is looking fine. Okay, so we have something like this. Now if you see one thing, this thing is these three different sections are not on this not over here. It is half on this and half at the bottom. So let's see how to do that. For that we'll have to remove this thing from here and put it in a new column. So first what we'll do is we'll click on this button which says add a new section and select the first one, single column, and now drag this thing over here to this thing. Okay, what we have added just now. Now this is how it will look. Okay, now this is not on this section. Now to bring it on this section, first we'll need some gap at the bottom of that section, at the top section. So what you'll do is select this one, edit section at the top, go to advanced. Let's add some gap at bottom. So let's make, instead of 100, let's make it 300. Okay, now we have some decent amount of gap over here. Now we can bring this thing above. So select this section now, go to advanced, and first delink this. So click on this and in the top margin, put it to something like 150. And before that 150, put a minus sign. Okay, so it will be minus 150. Now this is how it will look. Now we need to increase it a bit. So let's make it minus 250. Okay, so this is looking exactly like we have on the demo website. Okay, exactly like this. Now click on update. Okay, fine. So now let's start doing some more changes. Let's see how to change the icon, the text color, and all these things, and also how to put this animation. When you hover over this, we get this shadow. How to do that? Let's see that. First, select this thing, click on over here, and instead of star, we want this history icon. So search for history over here, type in history, and you'll get this icon, select it. Okay. And instead of print design, we want it to say history. So here, if you see, let me search for that. Yeah, here it is, title. Instead of print design, just type in history, and now we have it. Now go to design or go to style. In the secondary color, select this, and what we have? We have dark blue color, select this one. Now go to content at the bottom. Again, instead of this black color, select dark blue. Okay, so this is how it is looking now. And after this, what we have to do? We have to put this thing. Okay, as you can see, the corners over here are a little bit rounded, and we have a very nice shadow at the bottom of this column. So let's do that. So hover here and click on this edit column. Okay, now go to style, border, and border radius, let's put 10. Okay, or maybe let's increase this to 20. Okay, I think we don't have to put it over here. We can put it on this thing as okay. So click on this icon again, go to style, not style, go to advanced, and here it is, border. Okay, let's put 10 pixels border radius, and yeah, it is looking better. You can increase this as well if you want. You can make it 20. It will become more like this. Now we also have to add some shadow. So here, if you see at the bottom here, it says box shadow. So click on this pencil button. Now if you want, you can increase the spread. When you increase this thing, the shadow will spread, and you can change the color of the shadow. If you want to make it a little darker, you can select something like this. Now you can see it more clearly, but we don't want something like this. We want something like this. Yeah, this is looking better. And we also have to change the spread. Let's change it, decrease the spread to maybe one is fine. Now I just noticed one thing, that the speed is quite slow. So we will see, we'll have to change that as well. Okay, first let's see how to do all these things. So we have this thing like this. Now we also have to change the hover effect. Now this is for regular effect, and now if you want to change the hover effect, we have it over here, select hover, and first we have to change the hover color. So when we hover this, it becomes green, which is looking terrible. So let's change this and again select the same color. As you can see, okay, this is not the one, I'm sorry. This is for this section. This is not for the icon. This is for the border, and we don't want any border. So we can just clear this thing, or we can select this light gray color. Okay, that will be much better. And here we have transition duration. Delete or change this and make it one. Just make it one. Okay. Now again, we want some box shadow. So click on this. Now this time earlier it was, the spread was 1, and now we want the spread to be maybe 5. Yeah, 5 is looking better. And also change the color and make it more darker. Okay, as you can see now the spread is more like this one. Okay, and the border radius was 25, so let's make it 25 again. Click on update. Let's see how it is looking at present. So this is how it is looking. As you can see, we have this spray, we have this box shadow, and we also have this corners rounded. Now when we hover this, as you can see, the shadow becomes more darker. Okay, so this is how you do it. Okay, let's change the hover color because this green is looking terrible. So again, click on this and go to style. Now here we have icon hover, here it is. Change this and let's put something like this, or maybe let's put the same color, this blue color. Now as you can see, when I hover, only the size of the icon changes, but the color remains same. Okay, now once you do so, just click on update. Now do the same exact things for this as well. Now if you go to start doing all these things, it will take some time. So what you can do is, you can just delete these things from here. Okay, it will save you some time, and you can copy it from here, duplicate it, bring this thing over here, bring it over here. It will save a lot of time. Now click on this and only change the title and this thing, the icon. So it will save a lot of time. For example, instead of this, let's select trophy. Okay, and instead of history, let's select mission. Go to style, change the color to this. Again, icon hover, or maybe content, select this color, make it look like this. Okay, so it will save a lot of time. You don't have to do this box shadow, border radius again. It will save a lot of time. Okay, once you're done, click on update. Then after this, we have this section, a simple title, then an icon and two different rows. So let's see how to do that. So this doesn't require any block. This is really simple. So what you can do, we can click on add new section, select the first one, single column, and first we have some simple text. So what you can do is, we can bring this element texting or the heading element over here and type in our story, make it center align, go to style. Let's change this color to something like this, or maybe like this pink color. Okay, now go to typography. Let's change this to maybe Poppins. Let's increase the size to let's make it 40 pixels. Change the weight to 400. Yeah, looking better. So this is how you do it. After that, we have this simple icon. So again, come back to this element section, and here we have the icon. Grab this icon, put it over here. Let's change this icon. We don't want star, we want heart. So search for heart. The color is same blue, which is fine. We just have to change this size. Okay, so let's change it. Let's make it small, like maybe let's make it 20 or maybe 25. Okay, so 25 I think is looking better. Now let's put this simple text, very simple text, some dummy text. So again, what you can do is, we can bring this heading over here at the bottom, paste in this text or put in your own text, make it left align, go to style, select the text color, dark gray, typography, select Poppins. Okay, let's change the size to 20, or maybe not 20, let's make it 16, or maybe 18 would be fine. 18, weight 400, or maybe 300. Yeah, 300 is looking better. Okay, line height, you can increase the line height. As you can see, there's a lot of gap between lines over here, so we can increase the line height, okay, to maybe 2. Fine. Now we want one more column over here, but we cannot do this like this. What we can do, we can again go to element and bring this column thing over here, bring this thing in the first column. Okay, we have something like this. Now what you can do is we can copy this thing. Now we can copy this thing and we can bring this one over here. Okay, so we have it exactly like this. Okay, so this section is also done. After that, we have this member section. So let's see how to do that. Click on add template. Now, obviously you have to go to blocks, and instead of services, let's select, I think it is called members. Let's see. I think it is called team. Select team. Yeah, here it is. Now we have so many beautiful designs over here, but the one which we have selected is this one. Okay, 6 images. Select this, click on insert. Okay, as you can see, this is how it looks. Now what you have to do, we have to make it full width. So select this edit section, stretch it, and instead of box, make it full width. Okay, now select this section as well. Okay, and instead of box, full width, and rest everything should be fine. Let's see. We still have some gap over here, and maybe that is because, okay, everything looks fine. Again, come back over here. Okay, here we have to select no gap as well. Fine. Now again, for this one, select this section, make it full width and no gap. Okay, now if you notice one thing, this is looking exactly like this one. And obviously, now I have, while creating this website, I thought that this section was so perfect that I did not change anything over here. You know, all these images, the animation over here when you hover this, it was so perfect that I just did not change anything. But obviously, I'll show you how you can change this. So suppose if you want to change this thing, just click on over here. Instead of this image, you can select this and add some other image, like maybe this image. Let's select this, click on insert image. Okay, we have it like this. So it's all up to you. If you want to change the name, for example, here it says Amanda Lee and web designer. So you can change this as well. Go to content. Instead of Amanda Lee, let's make it King Badge. Obviously, this is not King Badge, but we can put it over here instead of web designer. Okay, now this is how you change it. Similar, you can change this for all these different images. Once you're done, click on update. And after that, if you see, we have the same two sections, our clients and this footer section. Okay, so we don't have to do anything. Just click on add template, go to my templates, and here we have clients. Select this, click on insert, and we have everything over here. Okay, and just notice one thing, that we have some gap at the bottom. We have to get rid of this. So what you can do, you can select this thing, go to advanced, and bottom padding, make it 0. Okay, now we don't have any gap over here. Now again, click on add template. Now select the footer, click on insert. Okay, we have this thing over here. Click on update. Come back to this page, it is loading automatically. Now this is how your website is looking. I think we need some gap over here. Rest everything is just super awesome. Okay, now as you can see, it is so easy to create a website using Elementor 2.0 with the use of blocks. It just makes our website, and it just simplifies our work. It is really nice. You know, the design is cool, everything is nice, and it is saving a lot of time. So I think this is a really great update on part of Elementor. The blocks are really awesome. I love it, and I hope you guys are also enjoying it. Let's add some space over here. Select this, go to advanced, dealing this in top padding. Let's make it 100. Yeah, it is looking fine. Click on update. Okay, with this, we have also completed the about us page. We can just cancel this. Now let's create. Okay, I think we should not have canceled this. Let me do one thing. Click on this edit with Elementor again. Because what we have to do, we have to save this whole page as a template. Why? Because if you see, this is the About Us page. Let us open the Services page. Okay, let me open a Services page in a new tab. Now, as you can see, very much similar. We have this very similar kind of design over here. The About Us and the Services are very similar. The title, the color of the background, the three sections over here, the three sections over here. So everything is very much similar. So it will save a lot of time if we save this thing as a template. Okay, let me show you. Here we have. Now what I can do is I can click on this option, save option, and click on save as template. I hope you saw that. Okay, besides this update, this is the icon, the top arrow. Select the top arrow, click on save as template. And this was the, let's type in page template. Click on save. Okay, we have the page template over here. Now what you can do is we can just go to our website. We can cut all these things. Okay, did we do any change? I don't think so. Let me do update. Okay, we can cut this thing. Let's cut everything. Okay, now you'll notice one thing. When you go to your website, you don't see your home page. Now there is a problem over here because we have created our home page, but we still don't see it. That is because we have not set that page as our home page. We have just created a page, named it home page, but that is not actually our home page. So let's make that page as our official home page. Okay, so to do so, come back to your dashboard and hover settings from the left hand side and click on reading. Now here by default your latest post is selected. Select this one, a static page. And in the home page, select the home page, click on save changes. Now again, go to our website. Let's see what happens. Now, as you can see, we have the home page over here. So this is working fine. Now again, hover new and click on page. This time, let's give a title of services because now we'll create services page. And again, at the bottom, content layout, make it full width, disable margins. Header, we don't want the top bar. Header style should be transparent. And title, we don't want that, so disable it. Breadcrumbs also, just disable it. Click on publish. Now click on edit with Elementor. Okay, so now instead of doing all this thing, it is really simple. Just click on add template. Go to my template and here select the page template, click on insert. And you have everything over here. Okay, it is really, really simple. Now what you have to do, we just have to change all these things. Instead of about us, let's put in our services. Okay, and we can change this subtitle. Now instead of history, mission, we have already seen how to change this thing, but just a quick, let me show you very quickly how you can change that. Click on over here. We want the star icon over here. So search star, we have the star. And here it says print design. So instead of history, let me type print design. Okay, and let's change the color to pink. Everything will be pink. So let's make it pink like this. Let's copy this color code and come over here. I can hover first, put the same color. Okay, then content, put the same color. Okay, so very quickly we have this thing. Okay, now click on update. After that, we have this section, our services section, and we don't have this section. So we can delete this section. We can also delete this section, but we need these two sections, our clients and this section. So we can keep this thing. And above this our client, we can add this section, our services. So what we'll do is we'll click on this plus button, add section, click on add template, go to blocks. And instead of this category, we'll select services. So let's search for services. Here it is. Now, last time we have used this one, image one, and we have used the design one. And this time we have to use something like this. Okay, let's search. Okay, I think, okay, if you see this one, this is exactly the same section. Okay, our services, this one. So select this, click on insert. Okay, now as you can see, we have the exact same thing over here. Okay, we just have to do some very basic changes like we always do. Change the design. So first click on this, go to style, change this to dark gray. Now we have to change this colors to our color, okay, to our primary and secondary color, the style of this icon and the color of this text. So let's do that. Click on this icon. You can obviously change the icon from here. We have seen this many different times. Click on style, primary color, put in your color over here. Now when you hover this, it remains same, which is fine. Now go to content, again color, put in your color over here, fine. Now very quickly, let's do it for others, other icon as well. Okay, we have it. Now the consultants style, let's change the icon color, go to content, change the content color. Art direction, very quickly, let's make and change the color. Okay, now the prototyping style, content, good. Web development style, the last one. Okay, it is really easy. Go to content, change it just like this. Okay, now click on update. Now within few minutes, okay, just 2 or 3 minutes, we have our services page ready, and not just a regular services page, but a really beautiful and professional service page. Okay, I think this is really looking terrific. So this is helping a lot, guys. As you can see, we are creating really beautiful and professional pages within few minutes. It is saving a lot of time. Okay, so let's not waste any time and let's move on. And after that, we have to create the contact us page. Let's see how that looks. Click on contact us. Okay, as you can see, again, it looks very much similar. So it will be very easy to create this as well. Now let's get rid of this. Let's go to your dashboard. Now hover pages and click on add new. Now this time let's add the contact us title. Again, come back over here, main element, content layout will be full width. We want to disable margins. Header, we don't want the top bar, and header style will be transparent. Title, we want to disable it. Breadcrumbs, we want to disable it. Click on publish. Now click on edit with Elementor. Okay, now again, because we have a very similar design, we'll do the same thing. We'll click on add template, go to my templates, page template, click on insert. Okay, we have everything over here. Now first let's change this title. Instead of about us, let's type in contact us, and we don't want this thing over here, so we can just delete it. Okay, now we can also delete this section and this and all these sections. Okay, fine. So we have this thing over here. Now we have to add this contact form. Okay, let's do that. What you can do is you can click on maybe, okay, what do we do? Let's click on add a new section, single column, and let's get the contact form. Here it is. Let's get this contact form over here. This is how it looks. Okay, now it's time to change this thing and make it look something like this. Okay, so first thing, if you see over here, this contact form is quite wide, and this one is quite, you know, nice one. It is not that wide, it is narrow, and this is looking much better. So what we can do is we can set a width for this one. So select this one, edit section, and in the boxed, you can select the width. Okay, whatever width you want. As you can see, when I change this thing, we can see the changes over here. So let me put in 800 maybe. Yeah, 800 is looking better. Now what you can do is we have to add some background color. As you can see, background color here is white, and we have to add some shadow. So for that, what we can do is we can click on this hover here and click on edit column, go to style, color, and we can add any color like this. As you can see, when you change this color, the background color changes. We want white, so select white. Now because we have some gap over here, as you can see, between this line and all this thing, we have some gap from all the sides. So let's add those gap. Click on go to advanced, go to padding, first delink everything. Top, maybe let's add 40 pixels, right 50, bottom we need some more, so I'll type 60. And left, because we have right 50, so let's put left 50 as well. Okay, now we cannot see any changes over here because everything is white, but you'll very soon see the change when we put this shadow over here. So let's do that. Now go to style and go to border. Okay, now let's add a very simple border solid color. Put 1 pixel width. Okay, and select a very light gray color. Okay, like this one. Now after doing this, let's do border shadow. So select box shadow. Now as you can see, when we select this, we can see this shadow. So let's do some changes. Let's increase this spread to five is looking better. And let's increase the blur to, let's make it 40. Okay, so the spread is 5, the blur is 40, and this is looking really amazing. Now we also need to have this rounded corners. As you can see, we don't have these sharp corners, we have these rounded corners. So let's do that. Let's add border radius of around 20. Okay, we have the rounded corners. It is looking nice. Now again, like earlier, we have done, and we know how to do that. We have to shift this thing a little bit up. So select this thing, edit section. Okay, the whole section, and click on advance, delink this margin, type in 150 and just put a minus sign below besides 150, and you'll have this thing over here. If you want to increase this, you can make 200 as well. Click on update. Let's see how it looks. Click on preview changes. Okay, so this is how it is looking. I think it is really looking amazing. So come back over here. Okay, now what do you have to do? We have seen how to do all these things, but we have not seen about the form settings. So again, click on this form, and we have already seen something related to forms earlier, so we don't have to do it again. What you can do is you can just have to change the email. So select the email section and make sure you have your email address over here. Okay, this is the only thing that you have to take care about. And then we have this send button. Okay, I forgot to put the design over here, but you know how to do it. We have seen this thing earlier. Now after this, we have this thing, contact details, and then we have some box icons and some simple text. So let's see how to do that. Click on add new section, single column. Okay, and I think first we have to put some gap at the bottom. So first select this section, go to advance. And let's add some bottom padding of maybe 100 pixels. Okay, now this is looking better. Now we can bring this heading over here. Okay, and here it says contact details. So copy it, paste in contact details, make it center line, go to style, make it pink color like this. Select pop-ins, or you can select any text of your choice. Let's make it 40 pixels. Let's decrease the weight to 400, I guess. Yes, looking better. And after that, we have two different columns. As you can see, column 1, column 2. So let's again come to elements. Take this column, bring it over here. We have two columns now. In the left column, we have this thing, list, icon list. So again, go to elements and search for icon list, which is which is over here under general elements. If you see under general elements, you have this icon list. Bring this thing under column 1, and you already have three things over here. Now let's change that. First we have this phone icon, then we have the phone number, and we have some dummy number over here. So let's put that. Select the first one and let's select the icon. Select this and type phone, and select this one, phone square. We have this icon over here. Now select the text. Now if you notice one thing over here, the phone which is written over here is bold, and this number is simple text. Okay, so what you can do, first let's paste in, but when we paste it, you see the phone, everything is simple, but we want the phone to be bold. So what you can do is, before this phone, we can type something like this, like left arrow and type in strong, then right arrow or greater than less than sign. Okay, so we want strong between this greater than less than sign. Now again, copy this strong and paste it after phone. Okay, and just before this S, put this forward slash. Okay, now as you can see, once you do that, the phone becomes bolder. So this is looking better. Now go to style And let's increase the space between this list to maybe 10, which is looking better. Now go to icon. Let's increase the size of the icon to maybe 30 pixels. Let's make it 30 pixels. And you can change the color if you want. I don't want to do that now. Go to style, go to text, and let's increase the indent between text and this icon, and let's make it maybe 20 pixels, or not 20, maybe 15 will be better. Go to typography and increase the size of the text to 20 pixels. Okay, so this is how it should look. Now click on update. Now again click on over here. Now you can go to content again and select the second one. Okay, now what I'll do before that, I'll copy this thing, this phone number thing with strong, so that I don't have to put that strong again and again. Now select the second one, select the envelope icon over here. Okay, this one, envelope, we have this envelope icon. Now under text, put it, paste in this, and instead of phone, just type in email. Okay, and type in your email address over here instead of this phone number. So mail@mail.com. Now select the third one, item list 3. Here we have clock icon and we have some timing. So select this and search for the clock icon. And here we have the timing. So first let's type in time, and let's make it to maybe 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. It's all up to you. Click on update, and here in the right column we have some simple dummy text. So let's see how to do that. Again, come to this element section, bring this text over here, put in or paste in the text you want. It is center aligned. If you notice over here, it is center aligned. Go to style, change this color to dark gray. Change the typography, let's make it Poppins. Okay, let's make it 16 or maybe 18 pixels. Okay, where is that gone? Here it is. Let's make it 18 pixels. Okay, width 400. Let's increase the line height to maybe, yeah, 2 is looking better. Not 2, let's make it 1.5 maybe. Yeah, 1.5 is looking better. Okay, now rest everything is looking fine. Click on update, and after this we have this simple map. So let's put this map, click on add new section, single column, go to elements and bring this Google Maps over here. Okay, we have this Google Maps over here. Now first let's add some gap at top. So select this, go to advance, and first deleting this, and let's add some margin at top, maybe 100 pixels should be fine. Yep. Now go to layout, make it stretch. Okay, full width, and instead of box select full width. Okay, and column gap, we don't want any gap, so no gap. Okay, now it's time to increase the size. So click on this map and first put in your address instead of this London address. So I'll put Mumbai over here. Okay, now we can see the map of Mumbai. Or if you want, I can be more specific and I'll type in Cyan Mumbai. Okay, now this is how it looks. And you can increase or decrease the zoom level. As you can see, you can increase or decrease the zoom level from here. Okay, when I increase it, like as you can see, when I do it 15, this is how it looks. And I think this is the perfect zoom level. You can also increase the size of increase the height. So let me make it maybe 500. Okay, this is looking much better. Okay, rest everything is looking fine. Click on update. Let's see how this looks. Okay. Okay, I think this is looking awesome. This is really looking nice. Now let's start creating the menu. As you can see, this is how our menu is looking. We have this divider over here, which we don't want, and we don't have our icon over here. Let's see how to upload the logo, how to make a menu. So again, what we can do, let's delete all these things and let's come back to our dashboard. First let's create a menu. So hover appearances from the left hand side and click on menus. Now to create a new menu, we have to name it. So let's name this menu as main menu and click on create menu. And let's select everything that we want over here. So we want the home page, about us, services and contact us page. Click on add to menu and make sure from here main is selected. Okay, now we want the home page at the top, then we want the about and services, and at the end we want the contact us page. Now we don't want this to say home page, we just want it to say home. Okay, now click on save menu. Let's come back over here. Let's go to home page. Now as you can see, we have the menu over here, but this is not looking nice. We also don't have the logo over here. We have to get rid of this divider. So what you can do, you can click on this customize link at the top, click on over here. Okay guys, now from the left hand side, first let's change the logo. So you'll see that under, I guess, yeah, under header, select header, and we have logo, select logo. Click on select logo, upload the files, upload your logo if you have, or you can use this dummy logo which I have over here. Select this, click on open, click on select. You can edit this or crop this, so click on crop image and we should see our logo over here. Let's see. Okay, here is our logo. Let's increase or decrease the size. Okay, so I am putting this as 90 pixels width, which is looking fine. Now let's come back, go to general settings, and here we have header, border, bottom. This is tick mark, untick this, and as you can see, the bottom border is now gone and this is looking better. Now let's change the style of this one. Okay, this menu, it is really looking bad. Here if you see the menu, we have this white color, and when we hover this, the color changes, animation also changes. So first thing is that we want white color. So first come back, select the menu. Okay, now come over here. Let's select the link color. Okay, so first instead of black, select white link color. Now as you can see, the color has changed to white. Now when you hover this, it becomes blue and there's no animation. So let's add some animation, hover animation. Okay, so link effect, they call it link effect. Here it is, link effect, and we have underline from left, brackets, circular reveal. For example, let's select circular reveal. Okay, it is loading. Now as you can see, when I hover this, this is how it looks. Okay, and I just want some simple, like underline from left would be fine, and hover link effect color, let me select white. Okay, white. Let's see. Now as you can see, this is how it is looking, very nice. Now I also want to change the active link color, which is blue. I want to change that. Okay, let me see where it is. Okay, link color hover. Oh, here it is. Select this, select white. Now as you can see, even when I hover this, it becomes white, or you can change this to something like gray if you want. Now as you can see, it becomes gray when I hover this. Okay, so it is really simple to do this. Okay, rest everything is fine. I think everything is looking better. Click on publish. Now one more thing is left, which is this, the bottom footer section, the copyright section. We have to remove this OceanWP and put in our own name. So come back again, come back. Now here you'll see footer bottom, click on that, and here we have copyright. Don't change all these things, just change this one, OceanWP theme by Nick. Okay, so what you can do is, I also want to add some link. Now first let me put something and I'll show you how to add link. First let me type made with love, and instead of typing love, let me do one thing. Let me grab this love symbol so that I don't have to type it. Okay, type in love symbol, and here we have many. So click on this link. Let's open this link, i2symbol.com, and let me select this one. Maybe this one is looking better. Select this, let's copy it, come back over here, paste it. Okay, we have our beautiful icon over here. So made with love by Nayar Sheikh. Now I want to add this, my name Nayar Sheikh, under link. Now what does that mean? Whenever someone clicks on over here, as you can see, on Nayar Sheikh, they should be redirected to my YouTube page. So let us see how to do that. So again, go to Google and type in href html, okay, just like this, href html, and you will see the first link is w3schools. Open this, and here we have the link. Just copy this link, come over here, paste it over here, and instead of this visit w3school, put in whatever you want to link. So I'm just putting it this, okay, by Nayar Sheikh. Now, as you can see here, it says made with love by Nayar Sheikh. Now also want to change this link. I don't want the user to go to w3schools. I want them to go to my YouTube channel, which is this. So let me copy the YouTube channel link and come over here, change this link. Now, as you can see, when I hover this at the bottom, you can see at the bottom left, you can see my channel link when I hover this. Okay. Now, so this is also working. So click on publish. And let's exit it out so that we can see our final website. Okay, so this is how our final website is looking. I think we have completed everything. Nothing is missed. Okay, so this is how your website is looking. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. This was not a very lengthy and a very detailed tutorial, because this was not regarding, you know, making a website in specific. It was regarding Elementor 2. I just wanted to show you how easy it is to create a website using Elementor 2 using blocks. That's why I was using blocks a lot of times. Or else we could have just used simple elements and created it by ourselves. But I just